Good morning. I'm just getting started on a 4-day adventure out here in the Superstitions. I'm really excited about this one. And if I'm honest, I'm a little nervous. The Superstition wilderness is about 160,000 acres. And all of the access points, or at least the bulk of the access points, are on the western side of the Superstitions. Peralta Canyon Trailhead being a very popular one. But all over the west, you got the Wave Cave, you got the Hieroglyphics Trail, obviously you got the Lost Dutchman State Park and Siphon Drop to Flatiron. Around to the other side, you got the Crosscut Trail and Massacre Falls and First Water Trailhead. And all of these trailheads, and even Canyon Lake Trailhead, they all give you access to the Western Superstitions, which is where I've always spent my time, except for Reavis Ranch, which is out towards the east, and it's a real popular, like, first-time backpackers destination. It's a relatively easy hike. It's only 7 miles, a little bit of a climb, but there's year-round water at Reavis Ranch, so it's a popular place to go. It's just really hard to get there. You need a four-wheel drive. The Rogers Canyon, or Rogers Trough Trailhead, is where you park to get to Reavis Ranch, and also gives you access to the Rogers Canyon Trail. The question is, all these trails in between. Oh man, I am nervous. So anyway, day one is gonna be Lost Dutchman to the Coffee Flats Trail, and then Coffee Flats Trail all the way up. I gotta get on the Woodbury Trail for a short period of time. That trail's not maintained. Who knows what that's gonna look like. And then it'll come out on a dirt road about a mile and a half or so from the Rogers Trough Trailhead. So it's gonna be a heck of an adventure. Let's go. Right, we are entering Randolph Canyon now. Now we just gotta zigzag down this canyon, crossing this creek about 30 times. So that'll be enjoyable. But it's pretty out here. Sitting here at the convergence of two creeks. One is the Red Tanks Trail, which is going to go up to join with Hooley Bacon and then go down the upper LaBarge Canyon. Down into LaBarge Canyon and then eventually it runs into, I think, Dutchman 104. But anyway, we're not going that way. We're going this way. We're going to continue on Coffee Flats. From this point forward, I don't know what it looks like, but it looks like I have about 3 miles before we get to the Woodbury Trail. I'm only concerned about the pieces of trail that nobody uses. There's a reason why nobody uses it. Either it's just horrible or it's too far out, you know, and people get a little nervous when you get really far away from civilization, but I'm trying to get lost. You know, get me away from civilization. I, as much as I love talking to people, I could go all day today without seeing anybody. And if that happens, that'll be pretty cool. That's all I have to say about that. This trail's hard to stay on. It's not incredibly overgrown, so that's nice. But I can't find the dang thing. You know what I mean? I mean, where is this trail? I guess this is it. How's that for a camp spot, huh? You won't be able to see it with the GoPro, but I can see all the way to Hilltop 5024 right next to Flatirons, way in the distance there. Man, is this great or what? I lucked out that there's water right there. If there was no water, there's no way I could camp here. And this is gonna be my view for the night. This is awesome. Morning. Oh man, so windy and cold. I didn't sleep at all last night. It's about 7 a.m. I'm waiting for the sun to come up before I crawl out of here. I just bad luck with the weather here. Oh jeez. Oh god, I don't want to get up. Oh, good morning. Wow, what a windy night. I can't wait for the sun. Plus, I gotta get my juices flowing. It takes me a while to stop limping and gimping around on sore ankles and knees and hips and everything else. So, that was a crazy night last night. I barely slept. Felt like my tent was gonna get blown off the mountain. I've been there before. one of the coolest parts about the Reavis Ranch area. You know, we're in the deep in the desert. The superstitions are so rugged. There's just not a lot of, you know, foliage, certainly not trees. And all of a sudden you get into a canyon and boom, pine tree forest out of nowhere. I'm a little nervous. I reached out to the Facebook hiking group, or one of the Facebook hiking groups that I pay attention to, and asked if anybody had been on this, and everybody said, well, there's not much of a trail there. Expect it to be overgrown and just a faint hint of a trail. But I see footprints, so somebody's been here before me, and that's kind of nice. We'll see if it's bad or not. I did bring these pruning scissors, assuming if I get caught in some real thick cat claw, I might as well do a little trail maintenance, since not too many people get this far out here. Cimarron Mountain, which is the second highest peak in the Eastern Supes. It's 5,545 feet. Well, there's a cairn, but there seems to be no trail here. I can't find anything that looks like a trail. When it's overgrown like this, you kind of need to just know the topography of the map. I know I'm cruising down this ridge here for a while, so this is slow going. I'm in Fish Creek right now. Paradise Canyon, as it's called. Doesn't look like paradise to me. It looks like the opposite. Hey, man. Hey. Hey, buddy. You don't gotta be scared. I'll give you some dang peanuts. Wow. You are cool looking. Wow. Want me to leave you something to eat? Oh, you look healthy, so kinda. Oh, sorry. All right, let me get away. Sorry, buddy. Still in the frog tanks, and it's finally gotten to the point where it's totally overgrown, so I'm not even gonna mess around with this. I'm just gonna go back in the creek bed and just keep following the creek. It's not even worth trying to navigate through this stuff. It's, you know, chest high cat claw everywhere. I knew it'd be like this. but lucky for me, it's just zigzagging around the creek bed, so I'm gonna keep following Fish Creek as long as I can. It'll save me heck of a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. Yikes, trying to get to Angel Basin. As expected, the last few miles has been a slog up this canyon, just boulder crawling everywhere. Looks like it's finally starting to relax a little bit. Welcome to Angel Basin. It's 6 o'clock. I'm about 2 hours later than I expected. This was a hard day. Very hard. Let me get camp set up and I don't know. I don't even know if I'm gonna talk anymore. Today was rough. I'm so exhausted. Both my feet are wet. Oh man. It was fun though, but hard. Wow, what a gorgeous place. It's about 7:15 right now and I am just dragging. I don't want to get out. Yesterday was so hard. I went 17.9 miles according to the inReach. Just the canyons are just slow going. Beautiful, it's awesome, but very rugged, incredibly rugged. I gotta get packed up. It is cold, but and I could use some sunshine. Let's get going. Hey, check it out. I ran into Matt. There's one other crazy person out here wandering around the soups. And he's doing a loop that's even bigger than mine. About 70 miles?
About 80.
About 80 miles. First water, huge loop back to first water. And of course, you know, I'm starting at Peralta and what I thought was a pretty big loop, but I guess there's more to be done out here. How's it going so far?
It's gone good. It's there's parts of the trail that are a little bit challenging to keep track of, especially some of the more burned areas.
Oh yeah.
But other than that, it's great. It's fantastically beautiful.
Country. How about the crowds?
Yeah, love it.
We got some real solitude out here. Well, it was nice running into you. Yeah. Man, the Hooley Bacon Trail starts with a big climb right up this mountain. I was just down at Tortilla Creek a minute ago. On a scale of one to suck, the Hooley Bacon Trail sucks. Today, according to the GPS. All right, it's happy hour time, and this is my view. I mean, come on, that's crazy. Man, I'm lucky. Thank you.
feet from him, right?
I haven't seen him in 4 days, but he's such a chatterbox that he stops right here to talk to people. Oh, he cracks me up.
Hey, what are you doing out here? What a sweet surprise. I thought you were gonna meet me at the restaurant.
Close enough.
Oh man. Don't you look pretty?
I didn't even make it. Look at how far I made it. That's about it.
Hey, honey. Thank you.
Cool. I gotta have a welcoming party.
Yes, but your treat is still in the car.
Let's go. There's cold beer in the car. Alright, that's it. I'm not even sure what the final mileage is. I appreciate you watching. Now it's time for me and Mama to go enjoy some Mexican food. Thanks for meeting me, Mama.
You're